In today's video, I'm going to show you how to integrate OpenAI's natural language processing with a Google Sheet so that you can generate drafts of any kind of copy that you might need. Will it be good? There's only one way to find out. Now, you may have heard of OpenAI. They've made a lot of news recently with their GPT-3 chat algorithms, and we are going to be using those in this video. Now, to get started, there's a few things that we're going to need. First and foremost is a credit card. Now, unfortunately, to get access to the free credits in OpenAI, you need to provide them with a payment method in case you were to go over that credit amount. Depends where you are, what that credit's gonna be, but you will need a credit card to really make full use of what I'm gonna show you today. Second, you're going to need an OpenAI account. That's where we're gonna use that credit card. And then you're gonna need a Google account that we can create the spreadsheet in so that we can generate our content via the algorithm within the sheet. Lastly, you're going to need a willingness to copy and paste code. It's pretty straightforward, but if you're allergic to code windows, this maybe isn't for you, but I can pretty much guarantee this is the easiest code-related setup you're probably ever gonna get. So why not give it a try? Before we kick into it, I need to ask you to like and subscribe to this video. I wasn't popular in high school and I need your approval to keep going. The steps we're gonna take are pretty straightforward. We're gonna create a spreadsheet, copy some app script in, update our secret key, and then run a test query. To get started, we're going to need a Google Sheet to put everything into. So I'm just gonna go ahead and create a new Google Sheet, and I'm gonna call it Connecting to OpenAI. Now, the code we're going to use to make this connection was done by Abhi Raja, a developer who's much better at coding than me and was kind enough to open source his work. So you can use the link in the description below to click over to this GitHub page with the code. If you'd like, you can download the code as a zip here, or you can just highlight and copy the code, and then click back over to our spreadsheet. And we're gonna paste this into the app script area, which is available under extensions and then app script, and it will open a new window. Now, if you've never really looked at this before, there's not a lot you need to understand. Your files are on the left. Libraries and services, absolutely not required for this particular install. And this existing function that's in here, we're just going to select it all with Control A and delete it, and then paste in the code from our new friend, Abhi. Now that that's in there, I'm gonna give it a name, OpenAI Connect. You can call it Pickles if you'd like. And you can just go ahead and hit save, and you'll see you're getting a syntax error from line one. So up here on line one, we have a constant and it's called secret key. And there's a thing right here in big all caps letters. It says, enter your secret key here. Now, for those of you that aren't super familiar with coding, the secret key is a unique identifier that OpenAI gives your account so that they know who to charge when the requests come in and they send the AI generated data back. To get your API key, just go to your OpenAI account and in the top right, click your username and choose View API Keys, and it will take you to the API key page. Surprise. And you'll see in the middle here, you have the option to create a secret key. So you just go ahead and create a new API key, copy that value and click OK, and then go back to your app script window and paste your API key in here. Since this is an alphanumeric value, you need to put quotes around it so that the script knows to recognize it as a string. If that went over your head, that's totally fine. You don't need to understand it. You just need to click save. Now you see the error is gone and all of the functions should be available to us now. For those of you that are somewhat interested in the code, the main thing to understand is we will use the function called AI to access the OpenAI configuration. And it's right here, and you'll see the format is the prompt, the temperature, and the model. And we're telling it to use the DaVinci 3 model. So if you're curious as to how much this is gonna cost, go to the pricing page on OpenAI and look for the usage cost. As you can see here, the DaVinci model is 2 cents per 1,000 tokens. 1,000 tokens is about 750 words. this paragraph is 35 tokens. So there is a cost involved. Be aware with it while you're playing around. One thing you'll definitely want to be aware of is this one right here, the temperature. The temperature you send the algorithm decides how creative it's going to be. So if you need it to be very direct and literal, maybe you would go with a 0.2. If you want it to be off doing its own thing, using lots of adverbs, 0.7 or 8 is more what you're going to set that at. For most applications, I found 4 to give me at least a good draft to start with. Now we're ready to run our test query. I'm going to just make this area a little larger so it's nicer to look at. And then up here in the effects window, we're going to call the AI function that we just looked at. So we're gonna say equals AI, and then we're gonna prompt it with what we're looking for. We'll start with something simple like a tweet. So write a tweet about how cool AI is. Then you close the quote for your prompt and put a 1 in there and wait, and we'll see what we get. AI is changing the world, exclamation point. It's incredible how much we can do with AI, hashtag, because we told it to do a tweet. From understanding human speech to diagnosing diseases, amazing tech trends. Now, considering the amount of effort that went into that, I would call that a win. One way to get different results is give it a role to play. So to modify this tweet, we could say, write a tweet about how cool AI is from the perspective of a baseball coach. Wait again. Now each time I'm hitting enter, it is using tokens, but it's gonna be a few cents at this point. I'm loving how AI is revolutionizing the way we coach baseball. It's helping us keep our players at the peak of their game. As you can see, it's already modified its response to that perspective. Now, keep in mind, it's AI. Its perspective is taken from things that it's read and inputted. So sometimes it'll say some crazy stuff, but it is one way that you can tune the results you're getting as you're playing around with different queries. And that's pretty much it. From this point, let your imagination go wild, bounce ideas off of it, see what kind of results you get. You can do things like ask it questions or have it rephrase things. My main suggestion would be to experiment with it and understand that you almost always are going to do some editing. It doesn't know everything. In fact, one thing to note is its knowledge base ends at 2020. So if you do try to ask about current events, it's not going to give you anything. Often it will respond by telling you it doesn't know anything that recent. So be mindful of the types of questions you're asking and the type of content you're looking to generate. Remember, it's a tool, not a perfect solution. In the future, I will be making some videos on how to do specific types of content drafts using this type of setup. So if you have any suggestions or questions, put them in the comments below, and I'll do my best to make some content around that in the future. Have a good one.